So, first of all, introduce yourself.
My name is Ferdinand Karobian, signed with Golden Boy Promotions.
8-0?
8-0 with 4 KOs, looking to be 9-0 with 5 KOs.
When are you fighting and who are you fighting?
I don't know who I'm fighting yet, and I'm fighting on June 23rd. It's going to be on ESPN, so make sure to keep up.
Anybody can get it.
Yes, anybody can get it.
He's the can man.
I see it.
Who would you want to fight?
I feel like the better competition I'm in when the ring, the better I perform. So right now, anybody, the only thing holding me back from fighting for a world championship belt is just experience. So once I rack up a couple more fights, you know, get some more experience in the ring, hopefully move up in rounds. Right now I'm fighting 6 rounds, slowly move to 8, 10, and then 12. And like you said, anybody can get it after that.
You're what weight class right now?
I'm fighting 154.
It's a great weight class.
Yeah, I had a lot of action-packed fighters, and I'm looking to make some noise within the next year or so.
Break it down. What do you think of you and a Charlo?
I feel like it's going to be a hell of a fight. You know, if we fight, I hope he still stays there when I make it up there. So it'll be a very entertaining fight. The guy is good. Can't talk bad about him. He's a world champion, been a world champion, has proven himself. But I'm going to come in with a hunger mindset, and you know, I got to take what's mine.
Jaime Munguia, they're talking about him and fighting Leon Smith. Are you familiar with both of them?
Not Jaime Munguia, but...
Well, he just beat Saddam Ali. I'm sure you saw
that. Yeah.
Okay. I knew that. Yeah. Okay, him, Leon Smith fought Canelo. He's established at that weight class.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, Canelo just... You know, outboxed him. You know, Canelo's a very technical fighter. How he fights in the ring, you know, picks and chooses his spots. You know, never lets himself too open where, you know, he's taking too much damage. And that's kind of what I'm looking to be. You know, I'm not trying to get in there, you know, to get hit a lot. I'm just trying to hit and not get hit. That's the sweet
sign. That's the key to boxing.
Yeah.
Give me your top 3 pound-for-pound fighters right now.
I gotta go with Vasily Lomachenko. I just love everything about the guy, you know, the way he performs in the ring. Second, I'm gonna go with Gennady Golovkin. I feel like he put on a great show with Canelo and, you know, knocking out Vonis in the second round. And then third is really up for debate. You could put Canelo in there, you could put Terrence Crawford in there. You know, I'm a big Errol Spence Jr. fan where, like, you know...
Mikey Garcia,
you know. So the third spot is up for grabs for me, but the first two I think are pretty solid.
Who's the best, biggest name you ever shared the ring with sparring or fighting an amateur? So?
I fought with a lot of great fighters. I feel like the best name that I shared in the ring was Miguel Cotto when he was getting ready for Saddam Ali. You know, he was training. They called me over to camp. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to go to his camp because I was getting ready for the Olympics myself. So I was able to share the ring with him, and I feel like that's the best person that I've shared the ring with.
That's awesome. How'd you do?
I think I did really good. You know, I was giving him some trouble, you know. Even though, you know, like, people say he was, like, towards the end of his career, but, like, you know, he was sparring, and, like, I was the second partner up in the ring with him. Yeah, so, you know, I gave him some trouble.
It's a big confidence booster.
Yeah.
For you, if you can hang out with a legend, a Hall of Famer, what's the one thing you learned from that sparring that helps you even now?
I just saw the way he was, you know, how his camp was going, you know, the professionalism, and I feel like I brought that into my camp. Where, you know, like if I'm on break, I get back, you know, I'm straight back to work, always stay in shape, you know. And one thing that I did appreciate, like, he didn't have any, you know, slug sparring partners. All of his guys were top guys, you know, they were good guys. Where, like, you know, they were always pushing him, so you always want to be in there with the best, so you can bring the best out in you.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. 8-0, gonna be 9-0 soon enough. EsNews.com, Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Thank you.